Our next video in the Vodafone Smart Tab N8 lineup is going through the accessibility settings I love to do with every new tablet, mobile phone, or product I get to look at to see how easy and accessible it is to myself with a visual impairment and then to everyone else, and then can aid you as well. If you have grandparents that have vision issues, they might not have a disability, but this could actually help them, again, with hearing issues and a multi-range of disabilities. To get started, we need to tap the app drawer. So inside here, you need to tap then the gear icon. Once in your settings page, I've put it in landscape mode for the moment. So scroll all the way down to the bottom. You can also search up here at the top. And then what you're looking for is accessibility. So if we go from the bottom, 1, 2, 3, and then 4. So this is accessibility, and it's like Michelangelo's little man that is stretched out. So we're going to tap on accessibility here. So inside accessibility, we're going to have a whole range of features. So let me go through some of these, and then I'm also going to demonstrate them, how they can best work for yourself. So starting at the top, we have Talkback. So if I go into Talkback, Talkback is a great feature, and I use this on all devices that I test. So what we're going to do is just toggle this on. We're going to have an agreement here. Talkback will describe everything that is highlighted in a green box. So for instance,
when TalkBack is on, your device provides spoken feedback to help blind and low vision users. For example, it describes what you touch, select and activate.
You can use this to highlight the time in the top bar here as well.
9:45, 17%.
So then it highlights the battery percentage, which is good to know. Underneath that, we have switch access. So switch access gives you the ability to use the switches on your tablet to move around and use the device. Underneath that is helpful tips. This will help and guide you through your use of your tablet. It is automatically turned on at the beginning when setting up. Underneath that is captions that will put a text description when actually in use. We then move on to magnification gestures. So if I just highlight this here, toggle this on. So once toggled on, 3 quick taps of the display will zoom in, 2 fingers then will move around. One side note I just want to add is that the display is a little bit blurry on the text when zoomed right in here. 1, 2, 3, and you're straight back to the normal font size and display size. So underneath magnification, you have the option to change your font size. So we can go into font size here. So you have a scroller. This will make the text nice and big, which we're actually going to use. Then you have display size. So display size, again, will change the size on your display. Again, you have a scrolling system there at the top. Click after mouse pointer stops moving, so you can link this up with a mouse. You have high contrast text. So once toggled on, we'll actually make the text bolder and easier to read, especially for myself. The power button will end calls. You have auto screen rotate, which is automatically on, as you can turn it into landscape or portrait mode. We have speak password. Again, when using a mouse, you can have a large mouse pointer. We then have mono audio, so you can change the audio systems on this tablet. Accessibility shortcut is next, and this is where we can add a shortcut to get into these settings straight away. Again, like I said, you can search your tablet for these settings. Text to speak output, touch and hold delay. A 3-finger screenshot is available on here, so you can use 3 fingers to take a screenshot. You have color inversion and color correction down at the bottom. So when color inversion is on, it will flip the colors, so now you have a black background with white text. Then finally, we have color correction, which will help with red and green issues that some people can't see. Also, there is another option I just want to show you. So if you click the menu button here, then go into display. When in display, you can see night mode here. So I want to just click into night mode. So when night mode is turned on, as you can see, the colors warm up and it's a little bit easier on your eyes to read. So when I press the home button, all the colors have warmed up. They're not so sharp and not so strong on my eyesight. So this is just a feature that I want to bring and show you that is able to maybe ease and help you use your tablet at nighttime. A lot of people use their tablets at nighttime. So this tablet offers a great range of accessibility settings. I hope you find the setting that you need or require maybe with your disability that is in here, or like I said, if it helps some people use their tablet in a better way, it is in here. If you do have any questions or comments, please do let me know. The one little side note that I want to add, TalkBack does work on here okay, but it seems to stumble or stick sometimes, which means it won't go through the menu. It's not a flowing sort of system that we have seen maybe on the V8 that I'm used to, but that is due to the processor and the RAM that is needed to use this feature. When you're flying through the display so quickly, like I do, if you go a little bit slower, it works absolutely perfectly fine. And thanks always for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye for now.